Bonjour tout le monde. On vient de passer deux jours très productifs ici à Bruxelles, où on a fait du gros travail avec les dirigeants à travers le monde et l'OTAN. We came here to continue to do our part to ensure that all leaders stand strong and united to support Ukraine against Russia, and that our resolve continues to stay strong for as long as it takes. Putin needs to know that there will be no erosion of our determination and that the catastrophic costs of our sanctions will only grow over time as they punish him and his friends. Yesterday, I sat down with President von der Leyen of the European Commission and President Metsola of the European Parliament, as well as Prime Minister Sanna Marin of Finland. Today, I got to sit down with fellow NATO leaders, fellow G7 leaders, and had direct conversations with President Michel of the European Council, a direct conversation with Prime Minister of Japan, Fumio Kishida, and we got to hear twice from President Zelensky as he continues to demonstrate extraordinary leadership in the face of incredibly difficult situations. L'invasion illégale de Vladimir Poutine en Ukraine menace la sécurité de l'Europe et du monde, ainsi que celle des démocraties. Les alliés de l'OTAN continuent d'être unis dans leur réponse concertée et dans notre soutien à l'Ukraine et à son peuple. Today, we reaffirmed Canada's steadfast commitment to NATO. Canada leads the NATO Enhanced Forward Presence Battle Group in Latvia, which includes 10 NATO countries. And we've pledged up to 3,400 troops to NATO's response force, including air, land, and maritime capabilities. Earlier this month, we renewed our commitment to Operation Reassurance, the Canadian Armed Forces' support to NATO's assurance and deterrence measures in Central and Eastern Europe. In addition, since 2015, Canadian Armed Forces' mission, Operation Unifier, has trained over 30,000 of Ukrainian security forces, which means that as we see the Ukrainian military standing strong against the Russian invasion, the brave women and men of the Canadian Armed Forces can take pride in knowing they contributed directly to that. European security is important to Canadian security, and so we are always grateful to the brave women and men of CAF who've deployed thousands of kilometers from home to help protect Euro-Atlantic security and stand up strongly for the values we cherish at home and around the world. The world has come together to impose unprecedented and punishing sanctions on Putin and his enablers. Today, Canada will be increasing pressure by sanctioning 160 members of the Russian Federation Council who've facilitated and enabled this unjustified invasion, which brings the total of individuals connected to Putin who've been sanctioned by Canada to 964. On imposera aussi de nouvelles mesures d'interdiction des exportations qui visent à affaiblir les capacités militaires russes dans des domaines comme l'électronique, l'informatique, les télécommunications, les capteurs et lasers, la navigation et l'avionique, la marine, l'aérospatiale et les transports. Putin has and is continuing to commit war crimes and create a devastating humanitarian crisis. We'll be announcing the allocation of $50 million from our humanitarian aid contribution to the World Food Program, the World Health Organization, the UN Refugee Agency, the organization People in Need, and the Canadian Red Cross. Les bombardements et les attaques menacent les lieux culturels et patrimoniaux qui sont importants pour la culture ukrainienne. Donc, on va verser 4,8 millions de dollars à des entités comme l'UNESCO pour les protéger. Poutine a fait des graves erreurs. Une, ça a été de sous-estimer la fortitude et le courage du peuple ukrainien. Ils sont en train de démontrer comment ils peuvent se battre pour protéger leur patrimoine. Mais il a aussi fait l'erreur de penser que nous étions divisés. Ce qu'on a vu, et ce qu'on continue de voir dans des journées comme aujourd'hui, on a des rencontres exceptionnelles,
c'est que l'OTAN demeure uni. Et il a fait un mauvais calcul. On est fort et uni et on va le rester. Canada and its partners and allies will continue to work in lockstep to hold Putin and Russian leadership accountable and always be there to support Ukraine and its people. Merci beaucoup.